This is Leigh Kamman for The Jazz Image. Throughout the year, I invite you to sit in with me as I make the rounds of festivals, concerts, clubs, and cabarets in search of the jazz life. And once again, in search of the jazz life, I take you to New Orleans. It's May 4th, 1997, the New Orleans Heritage and Jazz Festival in its 28th year. But this year is far more important for the 100th anniversary of Sidney Bechet, the King of Paris, or perhaps the King of New Orleans in a way. Jim Galloway, it's good to see you again.
Oh, lovely to see you again, Leigh. Yeah, and it's great to be here, especially, as you say, this year when they are actually getting around to honoring Bechet in New Orleans. And
we're in a offstage area and a sea of goodwill. You know, when you think of Sidney and as he performed, say, in those days at Olympia Theater, performing numbers like Atula Kafar, and then later on Petite Fleur, and much later Les Onions. From your point of view, the significance of Sidney Bechet and his impact.
Well, I can look at it two different ways. There was the very personal impact he had on me. I only saw him once live, and I walked out of the concert hall a changed person. And I mean, really, he emotionally moved me so much. I was in a daze after hearing him. Just the power of his playing, the emotion in his playing, it was something quite extraordinary. From the aspect of his place in the history of the music, he was one of the great originators. And from Bechet, in the very early days of jazz, you can actually trace through Bechet, of course, Hodges, who studied with him, right through the line to Coltrane, who played with Hodges, of course, you know, but he was a profound influence. The playing of Coltrane on soprano is, of course, quite different, but I'd be willing to bet dollars to donuts that something rubbed off in his formative years, because Bechet was such an impressive, such a strength in the music. As I said, one of the handful of true innovative giants alongside Louis Armstrong. I mean, they were both from here in New Orleans, and both such amazingly powerful figures that stand over the history of jazz.
It's certainly late in the day in a sense, but it's never too late, is it, for recognition?
That's true. It's true. Never. And one of the things that I find really encouraging, I think for a number of years, the younger players were overlooking the traditions of the music, and I see a change. I heard a young player this weekend here, just out of college, or maybe still in college, I think, who had all of a sudden discovered Bechet and now has a passion for him. And I see this year in the festival here in New Orleans quite a resurgence in the traditions of the music, which can only be good for whichever direction the music goes in, because if you don't retain the traditions, the foundation is gone.
What is the link that helps to fire that up? What is the link that helps to fire that up?
Oh, I think when you listen to real greatness on an instrument, the style becomes secondary. If your ears are wide enough, if you have a broad enough approach to the music, you can appreciate the greatness in all forms of music, and in jazz, Bechet was certainly one of, as I say, the original sort of great voices in the music, who of course influence what happens. In classical music, the same thing. I mean, without Bach and Handel, Schoenberg wouldn't have been around, because that had to come first. Right?
Jim Galloway, what a pleasure to see you on this beautiful Sunday afternoon with low humidity in the bayou country.
Yes, it's just great. Fabulous weekend it's been. And then Monday and Tuesday of next week, we have the Bechet Conference, which will be 2 days of discussion and music and good food and wine.
And we hope that some of it will be committed to literature, printed.
Oh, I'm sure it will be. We have there's a tremendous number of great talents here who have devoted those talents to jazz and to the written word in connection with jazz. I'm sure a great deal will come out of this weekend.
I know that Fabrice has written a book in French, the definitive Sidney Bechet, and lurking somewhere is John Chilton.
Yeah, John's here.
Is he in the room?
No, I haven't seen him since we were at... this is strange for me to be saying. I haven't seen John Chilton since we went to church together this morning.